live death a while, be still my instrument. Savitri has essentially vanquished death, but she wants death yet to live. She wants death still to be her instrument. There is still a role for death to play in her scheme of things. Death has been all along playing the negative role of promoting the prospects of life. Without death, life in the present circumstances would not have been able to make progress. So in that sense, death is already an instrument of progress, is already Savitri's instrument for her work upon earth. But now what Savitri says is, you have to change your stand. You cannot take that negative attitude, the materialistic attitude. You have to play a positive role and promote life in a positive sense. Therefore, Savitri says, yes, you are necessary for a while. Please stay on and carry on the work. Until now, the battle between Savitri and death was going on in a very fierce way. At one point of time, death tells Savitri, I don't know who you are, but you are a mortal after all, and I cannot yield to the mortal. If there is a divine Shakti residing in your soul, if that mighty mother is seated within you in the depths of your heart, let her look into me. I would go and worship her. I would obey her command. It is only the imperishable force that I respect. I have no respect at all for other things. If that imperishable force is with you, let me have a look at it. Let deathless eyes look into the eyes of death. If those deathless eyes are of that divine mother in you, let them look into the eyes of death. In other words, death has already conceded victory to Savitri, but he wants to confirm that really she is holding in her soul the imperishable force. Savitri looks on death and speaks not. It is not necessary for her now to speak anything at all. Death has conceded victory to her. But then what happens? A mighty transformation comes on her. Savitri, suddenly the divine Savitri, that mortal Savitri who was standing in front of death, is now in a full power, full glory, standing as a mighty mother in Savitri's soul. A mighty transformation comes on her. There is a rush of the divine force from above into her being. Center after center in her subtle body get charged with the divine force. Center above her head, Sahasrara, center on the brow, throat, heart, navel, below, muladhara. All the centers are now charged with the presence of the divine Shakti herself. Muladhara, where the world energy sleeps forever. It is that also which gets awakened. And with that transformation of Savitri, eternity looks into the eyes of death. The deed is done. Savitri has conquered death. Live, death, awhile. Be still, my instrument. What is the work death is going to do in future? It is the work in the transcendental spirit. Savitri is going to meet death again in a transformed condition in the transcendent. He is going to be the divine tempter for Savitri. He is going to induce Savitri to stay back in the transcendent, stay with her husband in the transcendent. She has won a glorious victory and she is welcome in the transcendent sphere in the realms of gold, and Savitri could very happily live there. Savitri denies even that. Savitri says, my work is not for myself and for Satyavad. We don't need anything at all for us. We are native holders of those glories. It is not that you are giving me any boon at all. They are my right. And I can always, but whatever I want for the sake of the earth, for the sake of man. What I want is the life divine upon earth. And it is that which transforms death in the form of the Supreme is going to give to Savitri. Live, death, awhile, be still, my instrument.